Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist here at American RV in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And today I'm here to tell you all about the 2018 Keystone Passport 2810BH. This particular model is in the driftwood interior. The reason I love this floor plan is it's a great family model. You have the big super slide here with a U-shaped dinette, double over double bunk in the back, and a second door into the bathroom. But let's start off right over here on the kitchen. One of the things you'll notice is you have pretty good prep space here up top. You see they give you all this space over here, and they also give you double sink top covers. Both these sink top covers are cutting board quality, so if you want to flip it over, use it as a cutting board, by all means you can do that. But I do recommend only using one side, that way the other side still looks nice when you go to cover up the sink. When you do take these off though, that'll reveal your double bowl sink. It's what they call a 60-40 bowl, meaning that one is a little bit larger here. And this is great for washing and rinsing dishes. You also have the high-rise faucets, which obviously also aids in rinsing bigger pots and pans. Right over to the side here is the three burner cooktop. The front one there is high output. And in this particular floor plan, we also have an oven underneath. Now, one of the other great things about having a big countertop like this means you generally have good storage underneath. And this floor plan is no exception. Starting right up front, as soon as you walk in, you'll see these two big areas right here. And I kind of like this. For me personally, I mean, you know, you can do whatever you want, but if it were me, I would use this bottom one right here for shoe storage. Come in, kick your shoes off, toss them right underneath there, your flip-flops, whatever else. So I think that is a great spot for it right there. If you come around to the side, we'll open up this side compartment. The top, again, is the same big storage right there. This goes underneath your sink. And then underneath, you have these two very long full extension ball bearing drawers, which are perfect for your silverware and some of your larger utensils like your spatulas, serving spoons, things like that. Then right up front here, again, that same storage area. You can see right in there, you have enough room up top for some of your cleaning chemicals, some more storage space underneath. And then right over here underneath the oven, in my opinion, this is a great spot for your pots and pans. You can see that's nice and open in there. If we go up top here, you'll see your fully functional hood with a light and fan. Directly above that is your microwave. And then over to this side, you have this beautiful raised panel cabinetry here with the brushed nickel pulls. So I open that up, you'll see there's not a stile in the middle, so it does give you nice open space here, and that is good pantry space up top. If you take a look underneath, you'll see you have an LED light here, an electrical outlet right over to the side. That's obviously necessary in a kitchen. You know, you're gonna wanna plug in coffee makers, toasters, griddle, blender, whatever else it may be. That's where you'll plug it in at. Then you have a nice big window here, which gives you a view to your campsite and also lets in a lot of natural light during the day. Moving a little bit further back in the coach, you have your refrigerator and freezer here. Good space. You do have a cutout there for some taller items, couple of drawers down below. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. Then as we make our way back even further yet, this is something that I really love in this floor plan. This is a good versatile space here. It gives you some different options. You'll see the one side is hanging rack. I would certainly use this for the kids' clothes. You have a good spot to hang the clothes up there. Maybe you can put a small laundry basket down here if you want, or just fold some clothes there. The other side though, it gives you options. If you need to hang more clothes, great, remove the shelves. You want the shelves for folded kids' clothes, you can do that. Or if you want a huge pantry, this can all be pantry space right here too. And then you also have the additional cubby hole right down below. Right in the back here is the bathroom. We'll go ahead and take a look at this. I'll take a step in here so you can see. Right down here is your foot flush lever toilet. As you'll see, you have plenty of room. Great leg room up front. I'm pretty broad in the shoulders. I still have a great room when I am sitting down here. Right up front is your sink top and vanity there. You do have storage underneath. You can see that there. You have some plumbing running through there, but you do still have some usable storage. Electrical outlet over to the side, and then storage behind the mirrored medicine cabinet. Right up top here, LED lights there. Whoops, helps if I use the light switch. There we go. Right up there is your vent fan, so you can quickly help moisture escape. You can see your tub shower right over to the side here. Personally, I like having tubs in bunkhouses. I know it's a small tub. You know, obviously, you're not going to sit down there as an adult and enjoy a bath. But if you have smaller kids, you need to wash a dog, you're still able to use this. You can see the shelves running up the side here. I'll stand in it just to give you an idea of the space. I'm 6 foot. You can see that with the skylight here, I do have plenty of headroom. You know, so even if you're 6'2", 6'3", you can still probably stand in here quite comfortably. And right over here, you have your hand wand for ease of use when showering. Last thing I want to talk about is this right over here, and this is your second door. As I mentioned, I really like this in floor plans too. You know, I have some people that are a little worried about having a door in the bathroom because, you know, maybe you've never had one before. Obviously, you can lock the door if you need to, but I like it because, you know, again, it's a bunkhouse. The kids will probably be running in and out of the RV. They'll have to use the potty. Let them run in, use the bathroom, and head right back out without traipsing dirt throughout the entire RV. That's definitely a good thing to have. Right over here in the corner, this is your double over double bunk. That's what we call it here in the industry. And basically, it's exactly that. It is a double wide bunk over another double wide bunk. The reason these are so popular for a couple reasons. One, if you have smaller kids, you can fit two kids to a bunk, which is great. 300 pound weight capacity, so you don't have to worry about the bunks breaking down on you. Also, if you have adults that are staying with you, adults can sleep here, or older kids, you know, maybe they're right on that cusp of not camping with mom and dad anymore, you know, in their teenage years, 14, 15, 16, they can still sleep here as well. You'll notice you have a ladder so you can easily climb up to the top bunk. This is great for smaller kids. There's a lot of bunk floor plans out there that don't have a ladder, and it may seem minor, but it's generally your smaller kids that want the top bunk, and it's hard for them to get up without having the ladder there. You also have teddy bear bunk series, which is nice and soft. You can see how thick the mattress is here, so you know that the kids will have a comfortable night's sleep. You have a window on both the top and bottom, LED light on top and bottom, and you have an electrical outlet on the top and the bottom. I know that, you know, we all go camping to get, you know, get rid of electronics, avoid them if we can a lot of times, but I'm telling you, on a rainy day, having an electrical outlet up there and letting the kids play on their iPad or their phones, whatever it may be, will save you a lot of stress and pulling your hair out. So I do like the fact they can have their own private little space here. Then you have a privacy curtain at night here too. So if you want to close that off so you can stay up and hang out while the kids sleep, you know, obviously it's not going to do much for sound, but it will at least cut out the light. Right over here is the super slide. You know, great U-dinette right here. You can see how nice and big it is. That way the whole family can sit around and have a meal together or play a game together. And the great thing about a U-dinette is it makes a very large bed. It's nice and easy to turn it into a bed. Basically, you just have to remove these legs right here from both the flange and the floor, as well as the flange and the table. Drop the table down on these rails right here. Take the cushions on back. Put it on top, and that will create your sleeping space. Also, the bottoms here, the seat bottoms, I like the fact that this nice leatherette material. You know, if you have younger kids, they're messy eaters, this is a lot easier to clean up. You don't have to worry about staining fabric. Right underneath there, you have easy access on both sides. So anything you store underneath the dinette, you don't have to lift up the cushions to get to. You can just swing the doors open right there. Back up top, two large windows here, again, letting in a lot of natural light during the day. And right over here, this was a change that Passport made probably about 6-7 months ago. They went from jackknife sofa to a trifold sofa. It is a little bit heavier, which is why they were, you know, resilient to do it at first, but I definitely think it's a great addition. I really like the trifold. Not only is it extremely comfortable to sit on, but it makes a very comfortable bed. So, you know, you want to talk about a camper, you can sleep a ton of people. You have the two bunks in the back. You can sleep two adults here on the U-shaped dinette and another two adults here on the trifold sofa. So that is definitely an awesome addition. Now, on those rainy days I talked about, you're probably going to want some entertainment too. So right here in the center is your TV. This one is on a swing arm mount. So if you do want to turn it to be able to, you know, have a better angle from the U-shaped dinette or here at the sofa, you are able to do that. And it's also hooked up right here into this multimedia center. This unit is a radio, CD player, and DVD player. So if you want to watch a movie, pop it in and you are good to go. That unit is also Bluetooth capable, and it controls the speakers both inside as well as the ones outside. You'll see you have a little cubby hole over here. In there are two USB ports. And then right underneath here, you will see you have some good extra storage as well as additional storage up top. You have the nice tinted glass there. but you can see that storage over there. There's a couple different reasons I really like the bedroom in the 2810, and the first one is the bed. This is a true 60 by 80 residential queen size bed. So if you're sick of having the camper queens, where you know they're 6-8 inches short, you don't have to worry about it here. You'll get that full 80 inches so your legs aren't hanging off. You also have storage underneath. Lifts up nice and easily. You can see the compartmented storage there. That box is a grill. I'll show you where that hooks up when we go outside. Another reason I love the bedroom is right here. You have actual slider doors. I like this over a curtain. You know, it helps for a little bit of privacy, you know, and it just gives that more residential feel. Also, right behind the doors here, you have a spot to put a TV. So if you do want a TV, if you want to watch a show before bed, you can install it right here. There is a hole so you can drop the cables right down in to attach on the other side. If we take a look at the sides of the bed, you have nice mirrored wardrobe on both sides. You can see the hanging rod in there, shelf up top. Additional storage all the way across the top here. You have the tinted glass, but good storage there. LED lights underneath for reading as well. And on both sides here, you do have a window, and this one over here is an emergency exit. Now that we've seen the inside, let's take a look at the outside of the Keystone Passport 2810. Starting right up front here, you have your two 20-pound propane tanks with your cover. Very easy to get to those tanks. Just undo these two thumb screws here, lift up the door, and that will give you direct access to the tanks there. Right behind that, you will see rails here for your battery. It is wide enough if you want to fit two batteries here, you are able to do that. And then right over here to the side, you will see this one does have solar prep right there. So if you want solar, all you have to do is buy the portable panels, plug it in right there, and you can trickle charge the battery. Coming up the front here, some black diamond plating, which will help protect the front end from some of the rocks and debris that will get thrown up by your tow vehicle. And then also right up front there, you have a light. So if you are hooking up or disconnecting at night, you have some added visibility. So we come around to the sides, take a quick look at the pass through here. You'll see it does have a covered hinge, so you won't have a bunch of rust coming down the door. It's also magnetic, so when we open it up like that, it's nice and easy. You don't have to worry about any tabs or anything breaking off, having the kids rip them off. And when we take a look at the pass-through, you'll see it is nice and open. You don't have any obstructions, you don't have any plumbing coming through or things hanging down. And it's a same size door on both sides. You can see the aluminum framing here that Passport uses. You'll also see you have an LED light over to this side in case you do have to get in there at night. Let's take a quick look down below. One of the other things you will notice is on the frame, Passport utilizes Huck bolts. I like a Huck bolt frame for a couple different reasons. One, the number one place your frame tends to rust out at is right at your weld seam. So by eliminating that seam, you help reduce the chance for rust to start there. Also, if you do get into an accident, a Huck bolt frame is much easier to repair. Another thing you'll see down here is this one does have an enclosed and heated underbelly. You can see that right there, so you don't have a bunch of critters that are trying to climb up there. It keeps a lot of the road grime off, and in those colder months, as long as you have the furnace running, it'll blow that heat underneath to ensure that your tanks and lines won't freeze up on you. Getting into the 2810 is quite simple. As I had mentioned inside, we have two entrances. This is your main entrance right here. You'll see they have three steps, the first one here being nice and low. You also have this large foldable grab handle here as well, which helps give you control when entering or exiting the RV. We do have a secondary entrance back to the bathroom there that we'll take a look at in just a moment. You see you have a large power awning. It does cover both doors. All you have to do is touch a button to roll that out. Same thing to go right back in. It does have an adjustable pitch so you can have the rain water wash to one side or the other. And then you also have an LED light strip there so you can just flip a switch and have lights at night rather than hanging up your Christmas lights. Underneath the power awning, you have two outside speakers. As I had mentioned inside, those are controlled by that multimedia center in there. That unit is Bluetooth capable, so that way you can sit out here underneath the awning on your cell phone or your tablet and be able to control your music from right outside here. If you need to plug anything in, here's your electrical outlet. This is where you'll do it. And then if we take a look underneath, you'll see you have aluminum alloy wheels. Not only are those beautiful, but also they're not going to rust on you, less chance for any kind of corrosion. And the Passport utilizes what they call load equalization axles, which essentially is a wide axle system. That helps while going down the road. It helps reduce sway, giving you easier control and better towability. right? Here's a black tank flush valve. This makes it nice and easy to wash out your black tank. Rather than taking a hose and sticking it down a toilet to wash it out, you simply hook the hose up right here. That black tank has sprayers built into it, and it will wash it out for you. This is the secondary entrance, as I had mentioned. I'll show you the steps here. They're nice and easy. You'll see they're folded up. You know, it's your basic fold-out steps, just like that. But again, you have all three steps, making it easy to get in here. The grab handle's not quite as large, but again, you're probably not going to use this one quite as much. Or, you know, if grandma has to get in or if you have a bad knee, I definitely recommend using the main entrance there. Coming around to the back, a couple great features back here. One, this is the arm for the grill we saw inside underneath the bed. So it does come with it. This swings out, so you know it's kind of off to the side here, so you can still, you know, see what's going on at your campsite while you're cooking. Then directly underneath here is your propane quick connect. That way you can take that grill, plug it right into there, and it'll feed off your two 20-pound bottles rather than having to bring the small green ones. Right over here is your spare tire. The great thing about having a spare tire on your bumper is it's really easy to get at. Hopefully you never have to use it, but in the event that you do, it's great peace of mind knowing it's riding back here, and it has the cover on there, so it should be in good shape when you do have to use it. And then right up top in the center is your backup camera prep. This is a pretty decent size travel trailer, so you know if you're thinking about possibly wanting a backup camera, this makes it a lot less expensive to have it installed. It's essentially a plug and play, which again is a great cost savings to you. Right over here on the off-door side, you have great additional storage. Again, as the covered hinge, the magnets there, and you can take a look at this beautiful extra storage area right here. This, of course, is underneath that bottom bunk. Right next to that is your outside shower with both hot and cold water access. And one of the great things I like about that location is if you take a look underneath, you'll see your termination is right there with both your gray and black valves. The reason I say I like that is when you're done doing your business and dumping your tanks, if you accidentally get a little on you or you forget your gloves, you can use the shower here and wash off. And right next to that is your water heater, 6-gallon water heater here. This one does run off both propane and electric. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is a 2018 Keystone Passport 2810BH. If you're interested in this RV and you'd like price and availability, I recommend you give us a call here at American RV, or you can take a look at our website, which is AmericanRV.com. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker. And I can't wait to see you on the road to freedom.